I'm Troy Kirby with Linwood Today with a quick look at the 2021 Washington State legislative session. On Thursday, February 4th, the Senate Commerce and Tribal Affairs Committee heard testimony on Senate Bill 5212, authorizing sports wagering at card rooms and racetracks.
We need sports betting to protect the jobs we have. Our 2,000 team members earn an average salary in excess of $70,000 a year. Without this amenity, it's one less reason to come to our facility and one more reason to go to a tribal one.
This irresponsible legislation seeks to allow sports betting into every community in Washington to the benefit of out-of-state interests. If passed, this legislation would cause real and lasting harm to the tribes and to the state's economy.
Also heard was Senate Bill 5103, which would clarify responsibilities for mandatory industrial insurance coverage for a person's transporting freight.
Briefly, so I bring this bill forward. This bill has been around in some form for several years now, and I bring this bill forward to try to help bring some clarity to this issue. I fear it may just bring more mud to the issue, but we'll see. I have heard from both bill proponents and opponents and from LNI that it will not change their policy, that essentially the bill will not do anything. It will not have any effect on their policy. It will just be the same thing as the policy that they have now.
We oppose this legislation just as we opposed the last several attempts for one company to evade their worker compensation responsibilities.
Is it up to me to pay workers' comp if I'm a one-man business? Because we have businesses all across this state that are just single people that have their business license and do all the things. And I don't think they necessarily fall under workers' comp.
We have concerns about the potential unintended consequences of the bill. It could be interpreted in a way which would be harmful for injured workers by rolling back workers' compensation protection from certain types of delivery drivers.
Over in the House Healthcare and Wellness Committee, lawmakers held a public hearing on House Bill 1348, which concerns providing medical assistance to those incarcerated by the state's justice system.
So we used to immediately, we used to terminate Medicaid, and then in 2016, I think it was, the state started suspending Medicaid. The issue specifically is that we suspend Medicaid the day somebody enters a local correctional facility, and the overwhelming majority of our folks cycle in and out frequently of our local correctional facilities for very short stays. So I spent a lot of this last interim really focused on jail reentry. We definitely have a lot of room for improvement for reentry from prisons, but for jails, there's very, very little support for reentry. And so I learned a few things. One of the things that I learned is that though we do suspend Medicaid, we don't terminate it. It takes about 48 to 72 hours to get the Medicaid turned back on when a person releases. And that's causing all sorts of problems for people who are releasing from custody and trying to get access to services. We've heard all sorts of narratives of people showing up at the pharmacy to pick up their mental health medication or their buprenorphine, their Suboxone, and getting turned away because their provider one is not updated. People are trying to get into same day appointments or next day appointments, and they're not able to see anybody because their Medicaid is not updated. It also creates barriers when we're trying to do direct transfers to inpatient facilities, inpatient behavioral health facilities, for example.
One of the negative consequences of working so well with Representative Davis, the healthcare authority, and the MCOs and others is Representative Davis takes all the great talking points that I had intended to use for this bill. Suffice it to say, we have an interest. Our sheriffs and police chiefs in our jails and our communities, frankly, have an interest in ensuring the successful reentry of folks who do find themselves in our jails, because all of them do get out.
Thank you for watching the Daily Legislative Report by Linwood Today, covering the 2021 legislative session.